Hello mga students, magandang umaga, magandang hapon, or magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. For this video lecture, pag-usapan po natin ang investment in debt securities. So dito sa video lecture na ito, it's more of an introduction. We will start with an introduction on investment in securities. So I will be presenting to you the two types of investment in securities. But we will focus on investment in debt securities. No? On another video lecture, doon po tayong magbibigay ng mga comprehensive illustration para po sa computation part. Okay? Now, ano po ba ang investments? Okay? So let us define the nature and okay, definition and nature of investments. Pag sinabi po natin na investments, investments sa hindi lamang po ito limited sa investment in securities. Kasi investment in securities ay isa sa mga klase ng investments. But investments in general are assets not directly, hindi po directly identified with the central revenue producing activities, okay, of the enterprise. Pero they are acquired for any of the following purpose. So, unang check natin dito, to earn a return on idle cash balance. Meron tayong pera na hindi ginagamit, natutulog lang sa banko. Pagkakitaan natin yon para merong balik, no? Let us invest it instead of the money sleeping in the bank and earning a limited ano, no, interest, mababang interest. Pangalawa, to establish long-term relationship with suppliers and customers. Pangatlo, to exercise significant influence or control over another entity. Okay? Pang-apat, to accumulate funds for future use, for capital appreciation, or for future protection. So, eto po ano ang mga reasons kung bakit nagkakaroon ng investment ang isang company. Okay, now, investments include the following. Una, investments in debt, in equity, and equity securities. So this will be the focus of our discussion. Plant expansion fund, equipment acquisition fund, stock redemption fund and sinking fund, investment property, and cash surrender value of life insurance policies. Now, since ano no, the basis or the reference of my discussions here ay yung ating libro ano, nila Dean Empleo and Prof. Robles, so lahat pong ito ay nakapaloob sa chapter 3. Pero class, no, we will be only talking about investment in debt and equity securities. Hindi po muna natin pag-uusapan itong mga ano, itong iba't ibang klase ng mga funds, IP, and the cash surrender value of life insurance policies. Although ito class no, na cash surrender value of life insurance policies, na didiscuss ko na po ito pero under income taxation ano. Pero for accounting purposes, okay? Hindi muna natin 'yan i-scope sa ating discussion in the next few video lectures. Okay? So ito po ang ating focus, investment in debt and equity securities. Now, tayo lumabas. Pag sinabi natin na investment in securities, going back dito ha, investment in debt and equity. So meron tayong dalawang klase ng securities, debt tapos equity. Pero ano nga ba ang securities or security ano, singular? Pag sinabi natin class na security, it's either no, an ownership in share in another entity. You are the entity, okay? You are ABC company. You have a security because you own certain number of shares in another company. For example, si XYZ company. So that is an ownership in share in another entity or a loan granted to another entity. You are ABC company. Nagpautang ka kay XYZ company. So meron kang loan ano na grinant, ibinigay kay XYZ company embedded in a financial instrument. I discussed the definition of what a financial instrument is in the previous video lectures, no? And dealt with in capital markets. Okay? So, etong capital markets, may detailed discussion po ito, ano, pagdating sa inyong FINMAR, financial markets na subject. Okay? Or equivalent, no? Depende sa school kung saan kayo nag-aaral at kung ano ang counterpart noon, ano. Now, ito po ang dalawang klase, no, ng investment in securities. Ito class na unahin na natin ito, no, na loan granted to another entity, ito po yung ating investment in debt securities. Because those representing a creditor relationship with an enterprise, you are the creditor, ikaw yung nagpapautang, yung isang company, si borrower. Okay? You granted a loan to them. So, meron tayong investment in debt securities. Okay? Now, what else? Etong pangalawa, yung equity securities, ito yung dito no, na nauna. Ownership in shares naman. Okay? Those that represent ownership in a company or rights, karapatan, ano, to acquire ownership interests at an agreed upon or determinable price. Okay? So, na-explain na natin, na-present na natin yung dalawang klase ng debt security, dalawang klase ng investment and securities, ano-ano naman po, no? Ang mga examples nito. So, mamaya, ano, sa mga susunod na slides, ipapakita po natin, pero para lang ma-refresh, maalala po ninyo bakit natin ito pinag-uusapan, kasi nga, ano, at the introduction of my video lectures on cash and cash equivalents and the receivables, no, pinag-usapan natin, di ba, yung brief discussion about financial instruments and from where ano I discussed kung saan pinresenta ko po doon na yung financial assets ay binubuo ng cash and cash equivalents, loans and receivables, no, natapos na po nating pag-aralan. Okay, eto naman tayo sa ngayon, investment in debt securities, equity securities, pero class yung derivatives, hindi po muna natin ito pag-uusapan dito sa intermediate accounting. Okay? So, tignan natin in the future, ano, kung sakaling magkaroon ako ng makapag-handle ako ng ibang subject kung saan tinuturo po, ano, extensively yung derivatives, edi kompletuhin natin ito. Pero sa ngayon, dito muna tayo sa investment in debt securities and investment in equity securities. Okay, now, eto na yung sinasabi ko kanina. Ano-ano yung mga common examples? For investment in debt securities, eto po ano, government securities, treasury bills and warrants, okay? Corporate bonds, convertible debt, commercial papers. Okay? Now, pagdating naman sa equity securities, you have your preference and ordinary shares. Pasok din po dito yung mga share warrants or yung stock rights. And the call options and put options. Okay, pero separate discussion po tayo dito sa equity securities. Dito muna tayo, no, sa debt securities. Okay. Now class, no, for purposes of investment in debt securities, ang pag-uusapan po natin sa mga susunod na video lecture ay investment in bonds. Okay? Sa intermediate accounting 2, yung liability portion, ano, pinag-uusapan po natin bonds payable. Pero dito, hindi po natin ginagamit yung term na bonds receivable. Kung hindi, ang term na ginagamit natin ay investment in bonds. Okay? Because, class, no, the typical examples of debt securities are bond certificates and treasury notes. Okay? Pero, for illustrative purposes, na for illustrations, you will see in the book discussions on bonds. Okay? So, doon po tayo mag-focus later on. Now, please take note of the following. Okay? The substance of a financial instrument, no? Ito yung tinatawag natin as substance over form. The substance, rather than its legal form, governs its classification as to whether the instrument is a debt or equity security. Ano ba yung substance? No, hindi natin tinitignan ano yung itsura niya. Ano yung form, no, yung legal form, kung hindi ano ba yung essence, ano yung substance ng financial instrument. Halimbawa, yung preference share, supposedly ano, ito po ay investment in equity securities. Kasi preference shares, di ba? Shares of stocks na may preference. Okay? Pero if the preference shares provides for mandatory redemption by the issuer for a fixed or determinable amount at a fixed or determinable future date, or gives the holder the right to require the issuer to redeem the instrument at or after a particular date for a fixed or determinable amount, is more appropriately classified as debt security rather than as equity security. Sir, ang haba. Okay. So, pag na-encounter po ninyo, whether in concept, especially pagdating sa mga concepts, no, theories, multiple choice question, redeemable, preference share. Okay? Oh. Ano ang nature nun? Is that a debt security or an equity security? Oh, we call it as, we classify it appropriately under investment in debt security because it's the substance that matter rather than its legal form. The legal form being a preference share, no? Preference yung front niya. Pero kasi may mandatory redemption at a certain time, okay, at a certain date. No, si holder ay merong karapatan na pilitin si issuer, no, na i-redeem yung instrument, no, for a particular date. Okay? So, later, ano, mas itatakil po natin yan. Whether under the investment in equity securities or under the accounting for shareholders' equity. Okay? Next. Ano yung nakikita po ninyo dito? Meron tayong piso, ano? Pero kung makikita po ninyo, ay hindi ko lang po sure kung nababasa po ninyo ito. Ang nakalagay dito, this certifies that there has been deposited in the Treasury Office Philippine Islands 1 peso payable to the bearer on demand in silver or in gold coin of the United States or ano to? Of equivalent value. Okay? Now, going back, di ba, sinasabi natin na yung mga typical examples ay bond certificates, treasury notes, no, mga government securities, this one. Okay? So, ito po ano na picture ay example na kinuha ko sa internet, no, for bonds, for equities or debt securities, I mean. Okay. Now, kung makikita po ninyo, ang face niyan, piso. Okay? Pero class, pag in-issue ito, no, chances are, likely, hindi po yan mabibili at face value. Na kung piso yan, ay mabibili mo yan sa piso din. Pwede mo yang mabili or ipenta, no, ng mas mababa or mas mataas. So, the face value, what you see in its face, magkano yung halaga talaga niyan, ano, sa papel, piso. Pero pag binili yan, pag binenta yan, maaring iba po ang halaga niyan. Bakit? Mamaya ano sa susunod na slide. Okay. Now, the debt securities, investment in debt securities. Alam naman na po natin na financial instruments yan. Okay? Issued by a company that typically have the following characteristics. Una, maturity value. Pangalawa, periodic interest payments based on a rate specified in the instrument. Pangatlo, maturity date. Now class, hindi na po ito bago sa inyo. Itong mga terms na ito na ginagamit natin, itong mga phrases, itong mga words na ito, kasi even before we ano no, we discussed this topic on investments, meron na rin po itong na-encounter na po ninyo ito sa receivables, sa loans and receivables. Kasi nga 'di ba, may mga present value computation din tayo. So dito no, meron tayong maturity value, the value of the financial instrument at the maturity date kung kailan siya magju-due, kailan yung due date niya, And in between, no, in between the beginning, kung kailan na issue yung issue date hanggang sa maturity date, no, meron tayong periodic interest payments. So parang sinasabi natin, no, na interest bearing, parang interest bearing note, no, pero ito hindi ito notes receivable. Kung hindi, investments tayo dito, no. But the concept of the computation are the same. Okay, now, debt securities such as bonds may sell at a price different from the face value of the instruments. So ito yung sinasabi ko, no, na pwedeng maibenta at 0.9 or 150. Now class, dahil pinag-uusapan natin ay investments, tayo po si sino? Tayo yung creditor, ha, hindi tayo yung nangungutang. Okay? Kasi kung tayo yung nangungutang, yun yung bonds payable. Tayo naman dito, investment in bonds. Okay, pero maganda po kasi ito na i-discuss ng side by side, eh. From the point of view of the creditor, from the point of view of the issuer, the borrower. Yun nga lang kasi, on the point of view of the borrower, of the issuer, no, pinag-uusapan po natin ito under intermediate accounting too, which is a different subject. O kaya nahihiwala yung discussion. Pero yan po ano, yung mirror image. Okay? Sila yung other side. Okay? Other party. Okay, now, bakit nagkakaiba yung halaga sa ano, no, sa value kapag binenta ito? The reason why is because of the following. Okay? The bond's market value is a result of an interaction of a variety of forces such as, okay, eto, no, risk relating to the bonds. Okay, what else? The credit image of the issuing corporation. Kumusta ba yung credit score, credit image nitong issuing corporation? Ano, yung mangungutang. Kasi kung medyo sabla yung kanyang credit score, credit rating, eh baka hindi siya makabenta or makabenta, makautang ano ng at a premium. Okay? Kumusta yung current interest rates, expected future interest rates, and the stated rate of the interest of on the investment. Okay? Now, class, kung titignan po ninyo ito, ano, this is the face value. Okay? This is the market value. Assuming one ano lang, no, isang certificate lang. Huwag na nating bigyan ng multiplier. Although syempre in practice, in reality ano, pag bumili ka or kung ikaw si creditor nag-invest ka, marami yan, hindi yan isa lang, pa isa-isa. Okay, now. Anong sinasabi dito sa baba? Kung sakali man ang face value ay piso, ang market value ay 90 centavo. Okay? Nabenta yan, nabili yan at a discount. Okay? Dito naman, pag 150, mas malaki yung market value sa face value, nabili or nabenta yan at a premium. So please take note of this one. Ano? Now, if you can follow me, doon sa libro na ginagamit natin, ano, meron doon makikita kayo na stated, nakaano siya, naka-box. Stated rate is greater than market rate. Bond sell at a premium. Stated rate is less than market rate. Bond sell at a discount. Okay? Interest rate equals market rate. Bond sell at face value. Okay? So, dito naman po, ano, if the market value is greater than the face value, we are selling at a premium. Okay? Please take note, ano, ito yung value and that is different from the rate. Okay? Ang sinasabi doon sa box, at hindi ko po ito na ilagay yata dito sa aking slide. Okay? We are talking about rates. Okay? Stated rate versus market rate. Okay? Pag rates ang pinag-uusapan natin, ha, pag mas malaki yung market rate, bond sell at a discount. Okay? Discount. Pero yung market value, yung present value noon ay mas mababa. Okay? Dito naman, no? Pag premium naman tayo, mas malaki naman yung stated rate as compared sa market rate. Okay, pero yung market value, yung present value niya naman ay mas malaki. Para maintindihan po natin yan, let's talk about an example, ano, later on. Okay, bakit hindi ito nakikita? Ayan, ano. So, eto, no, please take note here. Mamaya na lang sa ating mga illustration. Okay? Pero, please consider the following here. Yung makikita po natin, no, yung ginagamit natin na rate is the pag meron kasi tayo dalawang rates. Sorry ha, medyo na baka naguluhan kayo. Meron tayo dito dalawang klase ng rates, interest rate. Yung isa, yung nominal rate or the stated interest rate. Yung isa naman is the effective interest rate or the market rate or the yield. Okay? Yung stated interest rate is yung nakalagay, okay, nakalagay sa papel, for example, or sa kontrata. Okay, yung market rate is the basis, the determination, no, ng ating interest income or interest expense. Depende, ano, kung kaninong point of view. Pero again, we are at the point of view of the creditor. Okay, so anyway, mas magiging klaro naman ito later on sa ating mga illustration. Oh, please take note of the example. Okay? Usually, the issuance price of bonds sold at a premium or discount is quoted as a percentage of the face value. A 1 million bond acquired at 102 is purchased at 102% face value. Okay? Eto class no na 102 dito, ibig nito sabihin 102%. O, ano ibig sabihin yan? Premium po yan. Kasi 100 yung face value niya. 100% yung face value niya. Pero na-acquire siya at 102%. So, mas mataas ng 2%. Okay? Meron tayong premium doon. On the other side, kapag mas mababa sa 100%, sold yan at a discount. So halimbawa dito, yung example naman natin, if purchased or sold at 95.5, ibig nito sabihin 95.5%. I-multiply mo doon sa 1 million face value ng bonds. Okay? At the 955,000. Okay? Now, makikita po ninyo dyan, ano, sa mga problems, 10%. Okay? 10% 1 million bonds. O yung 10% na yon is our stated interest rate or the nominal interest rate. Kasi doon po magbabase tayo sa magkano yung mababayaran, makokolekta natin if we are the creditor, yung ibabayad ni borrower, no? In the form of interest. Okay, pero yung income at yung expense ng kabilang party ay nakadepende sa effective interest rate or yung market rate. Okay? Separate video lecture yung detailed illustrations and detailed computations, no? So, eto class, it's more of a, sabi ko nga kanina, doon sa, front page natin, front slide, introduced. Okay? Investment in debt securities introduced. Now, the market price of a bond can be determined by discounting the maturity value of the bond and its remaining interest payment at the market rate of interest for a similar debt instrument on that date. Now, kung maalala po ninyo, class, yung ating mga notes receivable, di ba, na interest-bearing. So, pag interest-bearing, di ba, kinukuha natin yung present value ng, okay, depende pa kung installment or lump sum, di ba? So, kinukuha natin yung present value ng principal, yung present value ng interest. Kasi, di ba, principal plus yung interest, that is your maturity value, di ba? Okay? Pini-present value natin yon para malaman natin magkano siya. Okay, yun yung ating market price. Yun yung ating, in this case, no, sa investment in debt securities, yun din yung market price, yung value, fair value ng bonds. Okay? Now, example, assume a 5-year, 5 taon, no? Yun yung ating duration. 1 million 15% XYZ company bonds are purchased. So the face value is 1 million. Although no, etong bonds na ito, naka-breakdown yan, ilang piraso at magkano yung face value ng kada isang certificate. Parang sa mga, ano di ba, sa ating mga equity securities, okay, mayroon siyang par value or merong stated value. O sa mga bonds, meron din. Pero eto na yung number of certificates multiplied by the face value of each certificate. So 1 million yung halaga nun. Yung 15% dito, eto yung tinatawag natin na stated interest rate. Kasi ang interest ay magbabase dito sa 15% multiplied by 1 million. Yun yung babayaran, no? Yun yung makukolekta natin being the creditor. Yun yung babayaran naman ni borrower. Okay? For 5 years. Ito yung duration. Ano? Ito yung term. Okay? The effective interest rate for similar bonds is 12%. Interest on the bonds is payable semi-annually. So, etong 15%, no? Di-divide natin into 2. So, 7.5%. Okay? Multiply mo ng 1 million. Okay? So, 75,000 ka every 6 months kasi payable ka semi-annually. Now, pag kinumpute natin, magkano ang face ang fair value, magkano yung market price ng bonds? We need to discount it. We need to compute it by getting the present value of the principal and the interest. Now, this is lump sum. Okay, di ba? 5 year, 1 million bonds are purchased. Wala namang sinabi na divided by ano into series of payments. So our assumption here is that this 1 million ay lump sum. Makukolekta natin ito after 5 years. Investment natin ito kay XYZ company. So si XYZ yung nangutang, siya yung borrower. May matatanggap tayong 15% annual interest pero divided into 2 payments. Okay, now, magkano yung 1 million ko plus yung interest na makukolekta ko every year, no, divided into 2 sa ngayon? Kailangan natin kunin yung present value noon pag sama-samahin natin sila. Yun yung market price ng bonds. Okay? Now, how do we compute for it? O eto. O, alam naman po natin ano, kung papaano natin kukunin yung present value factor, kailan natin gagamitin yung single payment, kailan natin gagamitin yung ordinary annuity, ano, or kung annuity juman if applicable. Okay? Yung 1 million, isang beses lang, one time lang, kaya single payment. Okay? 1.12, or i-verify natin, ha? 1.12 divide equals ng 5 beses. Okay? O, makukuha natin yung 5. Okay? O, sandali. Bakit ito? Ayan, ano? Teka lang, ha? Parang mali pa tayo ng illustration dito. Oh. Ah, okay, sorry. Oh. Ah, pag ganito class, no? Nagkamali si sir, no? Error noted. Buti na lang nakita ko bigla. Class. Eto, careful kayo. Kasi kung nagkamali ako, ano, magkakamali din kayo if we are being careless. So, hindi po, ano, no, foolproof si sir. Tatanga-tanga din minsan, ano? Okay. Now, magtataka kayo dito, bakit 6%? Eh, di ba yung effective interest rate natin ay 12%? Okay. Bakit 10 periods? Eh, di ba 5 taon? Plus, pag yung interest natin ay payable semi-annually, anong gagamitin natin? Ita-times 2 natin siya. At yung percentage, yung effective interest rate, i-divide natin by 2. Kaya dito, kung 12%, eto kasi ay annual payment. Okay? Annual interest rate, I mean. Annual rate. Since payable semi-annually, divide mo siya by 2. Okay? So, divide ko by 2. Now, dahil 5 taon yan, times 2 ka kada taon, edi magiging 10 yung periods. This explains bakit ang nakalagay dito, 6% for 10 periods. Now, pag ganyan, o di makukuha na natin, 1.06 divided by 5 beses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Kaya natin makukuha itong present value factor na 0.558395. Now, normally, ano, for classroom purposes, ang common na ginagamit natin ay hanggang 4 decimal places. Pero dito class, no, sinunod ko lang yung ating ano, no, author, kung yung reference book natin, dahil nakalagay doon ay 6 na decimal places. So, hindi ko na ito tinapyas. Okay? So, present value factor, 0.558395 times 1 million. Okay? Ito po. 1 million? Tama ba? Okay. So, 558395, ito po yung present value factor or present value, fair value ng bonds. Pero, for the principal alone. Huwag kakalimutan na yung interest ay payable in series. Semi-annually ito. So, dito naman, kukunin natin yung ating present value factor, ordinary annuity. So, kung ang nakuha natin dito ay 0.558395, okay? Oh, you do your way of computing, ano, kung saan man kayo mas napapabilis, di ba? Oh, ano ang pinakamabilis na paraan sa basic calculator? So, nanggaling tayo dito sa single payment na present value, minus 1 tayo, divided by 6% or 0.06, makukuha natin itong 7.36008. Okay, yan yung ordinary annuity natin. Now, tignan po ninyo, yung interest natin ay 15%, di ba? 1 year. Pero dahil dalawang beses mo itong babayaran, edi divide mo by 2. 75,000 ka every 6 months. Edi 75,000, 10 times, ito yung present value factor. Okay? Ang market value niyan, yung present value niyan ay ito. 552,006. This represents interest, etong taas naman, principal. So, ang maturity value mo, okay? Yung present value niyan ngayon, okay, is 1,110,401. Gamitin na lang natin ano, yung market price, okay? Present value ng bonds. Nakukuha ba? Okay? Ang maturity value mo kasi is yung 1 million plus yung ating mga interest, no? Yun nga lang yung interest mo ay payable ng in series of payments na 75-75 hanggang sa matapos yung 5 taon. Okay? So, class, ito yung market price ng bonds mo. Now, since ito po ay malaki, 1,110,401, is this sold at a premium or sold at a discount? So that is my personal question individually for you. Now, we can also do it this way. Ito yung ating alternative approach. Since magkaiba po ano yung effective interest rate 6% at saka yung stated interest rate 7.5 semi-annually. So meron tayong difference na 1.5. Multiply mo by the face value. Multiply mo by the present value, yung ordinary annuity. Okay? 1.5% times 1 million times present value factor ng ordinary annuity for 6% at 10 periods. Ito yun. Makukuha mo itong 110,401. And since, tignan natin, sinasabi natin ano, if the market rate is what? Greater than the stated rate, it is sold at a discount. But if the market rate is lower than the stated rate, it is sold at a premium. Ano yung ating interest rate effective or yung market rate natin? 12% or 6% pag dinivide by 2. Magkano yung ating stated rate? 15% or 7.5% pag dinivide by 2. So asan yan? Stated rate is greater than market rate. So the bond sell at a premium. So 1 million ang ating face value plus meron kang premium na 110,401. So meron tayong market price, the present value of 110,401. Nakuha? That is our alternative way of solving for the premium or the discount. And then, syempre, pag kinumpute natin yung market price, edi i-add or minus mo na lang siya. Pag discount, edi ibawas mo sa face value. Pag premium, edi i-add mo. Pero for you to find out if it's premium or discount, check mo, alin yung mas malaki? Is it the stated rate or the market rate? For you to find out whether that amount is a discount or a premium. Okay? Much of it no will be discussed doon sa ating mga problem solving. Pero, yan, concept muna tayo. For investment in debt securities, no, nahahati po yan sa tatlong klase. Meron tayong amortized cost, FVPL, FVOCI. Pero, para maintindihan po natin saan pinanggagalingan yan, at paano ba natin kina-classify yan? Ang sinasabi po ng IFRS 9 or PFRS 9 on financial instrument, kailangan nating i-consider in determining ano yung classification niyan by looking at the business model. Wow, model. Model ng business? Hindi po. Business model. Okay? For managing the financial asset. Ano ba yung, para saan ba? Okay. Ano ba yung plano mo dyan? Bakit ka nag-i-invest? Bakit ka merong investment in bonds? Okay? And then, the contractual cash flow characteristics of the financial asset. Inelaborate no, ni IFRS 9 etong business model for managing the financial asset. How do we determine? Yung question na how is answered by this one. Okay? The business model for managing the financial asset is determined at a level that reflects how groups of financial assets are managed together to achieve a particular objective. Paano ba yan minamanage? Okay? At a group level. Ano? Okay? It refers to how an entity manages its financial asset to generate cash flows. And this is applied on a portfolio level. Hindi po yan per instrument, no? Pa isa-isa. Kaya nga ito, group eh. Portfolio is a group of asset. Okay? Hindi po yan instrument by instrument approach. Na okay, may isa akong investment. Meron pa akong isa dito, isa doon, isa dyan. Okay, ginugrupo siya. Ito yung aking portfolio of assets. Portfolio of investment. That is how we determine the classification. Now, nabanggit ko meron tayong tatlo. Yung tatlong business models na yon ay etong mga sumusunod. The first business model is collecting cash flows that are solely payment for principal and interest. Okay? Di ba meron tayong mga installment? Sa notes receivable mo, di ba meron kang installment notes receivable na interest bearing. So kung halimbawa nagpautang ka, meron kang notes receivable 4 million payable 1 million every year. O, di ba? May binabayaran ka na 1 million for principal plus yung interest. Now dito ano, yung bonds, if the purpose is to collect no for solely for the payment of principal, collection of principal and interest, tawag natin diyan SPPI. We consider the debt securities as measured at amortized cost. O kaya nga, yung treatment natin dyan ay nagko-compute tayo ng amortized cost. Okay? The same doon sa discussion natin ng loans and receivables. Okay? At ang pangalawa nating business model is to sell the financial assets when there is an opportunity to generate profit. Bakit ka may financial asset? Bakit ka merong investment in debt securities? Ah, kasi ibebenta ko to pag tumubo. Okay? Kasi pabago-bago, mayroong fluctuation sa fair value at saka yung interest rate. So kung magkaroon ng ano opportunity to take profit, edi ibebenta ko siya. Now, pag ganun yung business model mo, okay, how do we measure it? Ang classification natin ay investment in debt securities measured at FVPL or fair value, kung saan yung differences in fair value ay binabato natin sa profit or loss sa income statement. Okay? Fair value through profit or loss. Ito, measured at amortized cost. Ito, measured at fair value. Differences in, as we will later, take a look, will be thrown at P&L. Pag pinaghalo mo yung 1 and 2, both collecting cash flows that are payment for principal and interest, SPPI, and selling the asset when opportunity arises, investment in debt securities yan at FVOCI, measured at fair value through other comprehensive income naman siya. Please take note that under our statement of comprehensive income, two parts yan, yung income statement mo or the statement of financial performance and then followed by the comprehensive income part. Okay? So, eto naman sa baba. Okay, now. Pag measured at amortized cost yan, please take note that interest represents consideration, okay, for the time value of money and the credit risk associated with the principal amount outstanding during a particular period of time. Okay? Pero, eto ha, please take note, hindi po ito kasama. The following instruments do not qualify as amortized cost. Yung mga derivatives na pinag-uusapan natin. Like options, forwards, swaps, no? Bonds convertible into equity instruments. Na-explain na natin, na-explain natin, hindi pa pala ninyo natatakel. Unless sa inyong corporation accounting ay somehow na-introduce na sa inyo yung mga convertible. Okay? Mga compound instruments. Okay? A loan that pays an interest rate that has an inverse relationship to market rate and a bond that pays a variable, please take note of this one, variable interest rate and whose maturity is periodically reset. Pag na-encounter po ninyo ito sa mga problems, sa mga concepts, theories, multiple choice types of questions, all of the following are measured at FV, at amortized cost. Except, pag nakita nyo yung alin man dyan sa apat na yan, yan po ay hindi natin kina-qualify at amortized cost. Okay? So, please remember them. Be familiar with them. Pag measured at FVPL, etong pangalawa, selling financial assets when opportunity from profit-taking arises because of fluctuation in fair values and interest rates. Pero meron tayong sinasabi dyan. Okay? At even doon sa overleaf, yung diagram sa inyong libro, ito yung mga arrows na tinuturo doon na papunta sa business model B. Anong sinasabi doon? An entity may also irrevocably designate debt investments as at FVPL. Okay? When it chooses to measure such instrument at fair value to eliminate accounting mismatch from the measurement of financial assets and liabilities. O kaya nga, doon sa overleaf, sa diagram overleaf, business model A, may arrow, tapos meron tayong diagon. Ano nga ito? Diagonal. Diamond. The diamond, na shape. Sabi dito, exercise irrevocable choice of measuring FV to reduce or eliminate measurement inconsistencies. If yes, pag in-exercise mo yung irrevocable designation, measured at FVPL. Ganon din kay business model C. Pag yes yung sagot, punta sa business model B for trading. Irrevocable, hindi mo na siya pwedeng irrevoke the moment na pinili mo ng gawin na i-measure siya at FVPL kahit under ka ng business model A or business model C. Alright? I don't know if it makes sense, Pero I hope na-appreciate niyo siya or somehow naintindihan po ninyo yung concept. So, yung FVOCI, ito yung business model C. Whether, please take note of this. Mahalaga po na malaman ninyo na hindi po relevant irrelevant, not relevant, no? Whether the instrument is quoted in an active market or not. Para masabi natin na measured at OCI yan. Okay? So the quotation in an active market is irrelevant for measurement basis para masabi natin na FBOCI siya. Basta ang business model niya ay both one or two, and two or A and B. Okay? So yan po ano class yung ating tatlong klase ng investment in debt securities. Hanggang dito muna po tayo. Ang susunod na video lecture natin ay computations, no? Sandamakmak na illustrations para maintindihan po ninyo itong mga pinag-uusapan natin. So let me know if you have any questions. Hanggang sa ating muling pagkikita-kita dito sa aking mga video lectures, no? Maraming salamat. I'll see you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.